Breaking news, a 3.3 earthquake in the East Bay, 1 mile southeast of El Cerrito. Now, the earthquake struck right around noon, which was about 16 minutes ago. Preliminary reports from USGS say the quake was a magnitude of 3.3. Again, it was centered 1 mile southeast of El Cerrito, and it was felt widely across the East Bay communities of Albany, Kensington, and Berkeley, and several other callers telling us they felt the shaking. We have Diane Bowe on the phone right now. Diane, you're in El Cerrito?
Yes, I was in the H&R Block building at the El Cerrito Plaza, and I'm sitting at the desk, and all of a sudden it felt like a freight train rammed into the building. The computers went shaking, and it felt like whiplash, and the sound was like a boom, really bad. It's like our ears are still ringing from it. It was really bad. Scary. Yeah.
You know, I bet it was scary. Obviously, living in the Bay Area, we're used to some of these tremors and, of course, you know, some earthquakes. But this sounds like it was pretty strong.
This is different. This was, I was in all the earthquakes since 1981. I've been here, you know, I live in El Sobrante Hills. But this one was like I said, the air waves, like it just like sucked the air right out of the building. And this sound was so bad. And the jolt was like, really felt like a freight train just rammed into the building.
Hey, you talk about the jolt. You were obviously in an office space. Any windows rattling or anything falling off the...
No, actually the computer went at a 45-degree angle and then it straightened up. And the lady, tax preparer, her whole chair was shaking and it looked like her head was kind of bobbing up like one of those Bob dolls in the back of a, you know, the cars. And I tell you, it felt like a whiplash. It was that severe or strong. That's powerful. And when I heard it was only at 3.8, I was like, oh, God. I was hoping this would be the big one and it would be over with. But, yeah, it was
well, obviously, because we talk about it so much. It was actually a 3.3. Diane, we're very glad to hear that you're doing okay and everything was all right in that H&R Block office. So thanks so much. Thanks so much for sharing your story with us. We are going to talk to David Schwartz now with USGS. We just heard it was a 3.3 magnitude, right, David?
That's correct.
Tell me what a 3.3 magnitude, what that entails. We just talked to two people who felt a lot of shaking.
Yeah, well, it turns out that the preliminary depth of the earthquake was about 3 miles, which is relatively shallow. And so 3.3 is really a pretty small event. If it occurred at 6 or 7 or 8 miles, it would probably hardly be felt. But because of the shallowness, the shaking seems stronger. But this is a pretty typical earthquake for that area. The event itself, again, the preliminary location, also puts it about 3 miles to the west of the Hayward Fault. And, you know, we'll just watch and see as additional information comes in and, you know, whether or not something else occurs.
Okay, David Schwartz with USGS, thanks so much.
Sure.
Roberta, this is, let's check in with Roberta Gonzalez right now. You're tracking this as well with USGS, and this is a good time to remind everybody out there, we need to get our earthquake kits ready, right?
We do become a little lackadaisical, don't we?
Just a bit.
We need our earthquake kits in our garage and be well prepared and always have a plan how to check in with one another. We know our cell phones go down when you have an emergency around the Bay Area or any kind of big event. So make sure you just always have a plan. But just to, again, repeat what they were saying at the USGS just moments ago, a very shallow earthquake. That's why it was felt by so many people. Also, it was really centered around three different areas, 1 mile southeast of El Cerrito, and then less than a mile than Kensington, 1 mile north-northeast of Albany, and 3 miles from Berkeley. So it was widespread felt with this minor event.